inside the cell, and cell is the most important structural and the functioning unit of all living organisms. Now when we talk about the cell organelles, we have mitochondria, we have lysosomes, we have plastids. Now we will discuss the concept on the cell organelle, that is mitochondria. It is one of the important cell organelles because it is that organelle in which the energy is being produced. That is why it is referred to as the powerhouse of the cell, because it helps in the production of the energy. Now when we have the mitochondria, it has a structure something like this. We have a cylindrical shape organelle. It is actually a double membrane, and then we have this substance. Now when we have double membrane, that is why we can say that there are two organelles, that is mitochondria and the plastids, which have double membrane. Rest of them, the reticulum or the ribosomes, the lysosomes, all these have the single membrane. So we can say that plastids and mitochondria have double membrane. And if we talk about the endoplasmic reticulum, or we can say ribosomes or lysosomes, all three have single membrane. Now when it has a double membrane, we have an outer membrane, then the inner membrane. The space between these two membranes is known as the intermembranous space, which is found between the membranes, the inner membrane and the outer membrane. Now when it has a double layered membrane, the space is known as the intermembranous space. The outer membrane has pores. That means it is porous, it has holes in it. Now when the outer membrane has holes in it, it allows the transfer of substances from outside the cell into the mitochondria. So we can say that the transfer of substances takes place from the outer membrane, because outer membrane is porous in nature. Also the inner membrane, if we talk about the inner membrane, it has some folding. So folding of the substances takes place in the inner membrane, and because of this folding it has some projections. These projections are referred to as the cristae. Now each organelle has a definite structure of its own. Like for example, if you talk about the endoplasmic reticulum, it has three important structures. These structures are known as the cisternae. Then we have vesicles. Then we have tubules. You must know the basic difference between these three, and you must see the video offered by Abhyas Online on the concept of endoplasmic reticulum. Similarly, there are different structures for Golgi bodies also, different structures for ribosomes also. So all these structures, all these organelles have a specific structure. Because of this structure, they have a specific function to perform. So function depends on the structure, and each structure is different for each different organelle. Like in the case of mitochondria, we have the structure of cristae, which is formed by the folding of the inner membrane, because it is a double layered membrane, double layered cell organelle. Now when we have the cristae, there is folding of these projections, folding of the membrane. Now when we have talked about the structure, there is presence of enzymes. There is presence of enzymes in the mitochondria, and this enzymes does the oxidation, or we can see the digestion of the carbohydrates. Now when the carbohydrates are being digested, these carbohydrates release energy, and that is why when the energy is being produced, it is known as the powerhouse of the cell. Now when the energy is being produced, it is produced in the form of ATP molecules, and this ATP is referred, the full form of ATP is known as adenosine triphosphate. This is the full form of ATP. Now when the energy is being produced, we call it as the powerhouse of the cell, and this ATP is known as the energy currency. So energy currency is the ATP, and energy is produced by the organelle known as the mitochondria. Now when we have discussed the structure, we have discussed the energy currency. Now we can discuss why it is known as the semi-autonomous. So the main function or the main feature of this organelle is that it has its own. That means it produces its own ribosomes and it has its own DNA. So ribosomes and DNA are present inside the mitochondria, which means that ribosomes, the basic function of ribosomes is the manufacture of proteins. That is why we can say that mitochondria has its own proteins, and because of the DNA, it has its own heredity characters which are transferred from parents to the next generation. So we have some genes. Now when we have the proteins as well as we have the genes, that means it can replicate or it can multiply itself. Because it can multiply itself, we are talking about the concept of mitochondria. So when we can multiply itself, it can multiply itself, that is why it is known as a self-replicating organelle. Self-replicating organelle, or we can say a semi-autonomous organelle. Now because of these two substances only we can say that it is a self-replicating organelle. So out of all the organelles, the reticulum, ribosomes, lysosomes, like Golgi bodies, all these are organelles, we have only the mitochondria which is self-replicating or which is known as semi-autonomous. So till now we have discussed everything about mitochondria. In the features only we have discussed the functions also. So let us discuss the functions once again. So the first important function is that it produces the energy consisting that is known as the adenosine triphosphate. The first function is the production of the energy currency. The second function is the production of proteins. Because it has ribosomes, and ribosomes are the main organelle which does the production of proteins. So mitochondria has its own proteins and has its own ribosomes. The third function is known as, it is known as a self-replicating organelle because it has its own ribosomes and it has its own DNA. So these three were the important functions of the mitochondria. That is why it is known as the powerhouse of the cell. You must know there are only two organelles, that is plastids and the mitochondria, which are double layered. Rest all of them are single layered. And the space between these two membranes is known as the intermembranous space. So this was the concept of mitochondria. You can refer to all these organelles in a separate video. This was the concept of mitochondria.